A note on OJ made in America. What a story. What a story. This is an extraordinary documentary. It's more than 7 hours long. It has been presented as a series on HBO, finished some days ago, about the trial that has fascinated America. As they show in the account, in the film, people were going to the bar to watch the court proceedings and talk about it, sometimes argue about it. What a character. It seems pretty clear now. It maybe was at the time of the verdict that this guy killed his wife. And it's still interesting to see how the politics play the role, that is, racial tensions, teams of lawyers, wealth, celebrity, because as they said, well, an ordinary guy would have been convicted, and there's no question about it. But he could afford a stellar team of lawyers arguing with each other after the trial. One said he will not talk with the others ever again because they played the race card. But then being a lawyer is a challenge. It's the, of course, the profession, the job that has the highest rate of, in America at least, and I guess in other parts, highest rates of suicide, depression, and divorce. So it's tough to be a lawyer. On the other hand, you can be ruthless, as we see in this documentary. And then the jokes, one of which says, scientists have decided to stop testing on lab rats. And there are three reasons. One, people get attached to rats stop using lab rats for tests and instead do research and inflict pain on lawyers. Why? One, it's because people get attached to rats. Second reason, there are not enough lab rats. And third, and maybe most important, there are some things even rats won't do. Which gives us an idea about the perception. And it's making the connection with real life. It's outrageous to see how, for instance, at that point when they discover many awful things in the past of the policemen involved in the investigation, and they brought up the fact that he was a racist, he said so many stupid things when he was, I don't know, 20 years younger. And destroyed his image as a witness. But then again, was he the guy on trial? One of the questions. Or OJ? Because this man insulted other races and had crazy ideas in his head. Does this mean that OJ Simpson should get away? It's also true that one clear division was along race lines. So for me as a white man living in on another continent, I still maybe I should not pronounce myself on the issue because I'm white, I don't know. Whites tended to see him as guilty, and black people, African Americans, thought in proportion of 70% or more that he's not, he's a victim of white racists. It's also true that they didn't have all the elements at that moment. So many years later, I don't know if they have a poll, but the percentage of African Americans who think he was innocent would surely drop, I don't know how much. Because many years after the killing, O.J. Simpson is involved, and not just involved, he's the mastermind of a robbery involving some of the things which have been taken from him by law, by court decisions, because in a civil trial, in a civil suit, he lost. Another jury, in another trial, they decided that he should pay many millions of dollars to the families of the victims. I don't know, 30 million or so. And because he wouldn't do that, some of the memorabilia, some photographs and whatnot have been taken in order to be sold, and some of that, many millions, be paid to the families. And so in Las Vegas, many years after the trial, first most important trial in American history, maybe most important, most watched, important. He takes a group of friends with guns and goes to a room and with a gun of the head pointed by some. They're told to give up their the goods which were in their possession. And anyway, even if you claim a right to something, you don't go with a gun. Once I blow your head off, I think it's recorded. They're on top of witnesses. There's evidence from, and O.J. Simpson gets convicted. And well, years after this other incident, and O.J. Simpson has just been granted parole. He's out after this robbery, this armed attack, and it was thrilling to watch. It's drama as we see in the movies. Only this is for real, with so many highlight moments. The glove, which didn't fit, but we have the explanation: didn't fit because he was taking some medicine, or didn't, for arthritis, and then he had another glove underneath the glove, and so on. He was exercising in prison, so the shape of his hands changed. Anyway, it's pretty clear he did it. He had the money to hire the best lawyers, who saved his. Well, I'm not sure if his life. He would be sentenced to life in prison. Maybe he would be out at the same time now, let's say, as for the robbery, but he wouldn't have been free in the meantime after the killing.